Please click on subscribe button and click on bell icon for more interesting updates on civil engineering concepts.
In this video lecture, I will explain you complete step-by-step process of designing of G+4 building structural model by using ETAP software with detailing. So initially, I will explain you how to take the modeling process in ETAP software. Then after that, I will explain you how to apply the load cases. Then after that, I will explain you how to analyze the building structural model, and then we will design the structural model according to IS 456-2000 code. So for that, firstly, I am selecting my ETAP software for designing of any kind of the building in ETAP software and detailing. So we need these two softwares. One is related to ETAP software and one is related to detailing version software. These two softwares are most essential one for designing and detailing building. Just I am selecting ETAP software here. So the software will be open here like this with the user interface. So it will be consisting of the file, edit, view, define, draw, select, some options here like this. So here in this video, we are going with the G+4 building structural model. So firstly, I will show you the plan. So this is a plan which is related to G+4 building structural model. So in my previous videos, I was explained how to design this building structural model by using StatPro software. Same G+4 building structural model by using StatPro software. So in this video, I will cover in ETAP software. So the complete details about this typical floor plan I was explained in my previous video. You can watch that video from above cot link. So this is the building typical floor plan, and this is the center to center distance between the columns. So firstly, we have to select the file option. Click on the new model option here. So after that, it will open your model initialization option here like this. So here I'm selecting user building settings. Why? Because we have to give the input according to our considered code. Select the metric SI system here and steel design as per IS 800 code provision Indian. So just I'm selecting IS 800 section here, and IS 456 code is the design for the RCC section. Click on OK option. So after this, we have to enter the number of grid lines in horizontal direction, which is nothing but the X direction condition, and number of grid lines in vertical direction, Y direction condition system. So here, X direction will be consisting of the number of lines are 4. Why? Because it will be consisting of the 4 number of the columns which is exist in horizontal. And again, it will be consisting of the 3 numbers in Y direction condition. Select the custom grid space only. Why? Because we doesn't have any similar center to center distance between the columns. Click on the edit grid data option. So it will open your options here like this. So in this case, initially we have to select the display grid data as spacing option. The first grid will be consisting of approximately the dimensions is 4.7 here, and second grid will be consisting of approximately the dimensions is 5.38 here, and the next number of the grid which is consisting of the approximately the dimensions is 6.3 here. Just I'm entering here like this. So again, in the same process, it will be consisting of Y direction spacing also. So Y direction spacing is first grid will be of 4.26 here, and the second grid will be of approximately 4.88 here. So here I'm taking from this direction for the east facing direction. You can consider from this direction also. So this is my second bedroom section, and this is the hall section, this is the kitchen and etc. for this. So here I'm considering from this direction. Click on OK option. Now we have to enter the number of the stories on the right hand side section, which is of 5 numbers, and each story will be consisting of 3 meter, and bottom story is also we have to enter here. Click on the grid only option from the add structural objects here. So it will be consisting of the blank, steel deck, struggled truss, flat slab, flat slab with perimeter beams and wolf slab, two-way slab system, ribbed slab. So here we have to consider grid only option. Click on OK. So that the grid structural model, which is related to the 2D as well as the 3D, open in window 1 as well as the window 2 here. So in the window 1, it will be consisting of the 2D floor plan, so 2D center to center distance between the members, and in the window 2, it will be open your 3D model. So after the grid data, we had to define the material properties like grade of the concrete as well as the grade of the steel. For that, select the define option, material properties, click on define option. Here in this case example, just I'm taking same M25 grade concrete provision. Just I'm selecting Indian concrete, select M25 grade, click on OK. Click on OK again. So again, we have to add the steel grade also. Just I'm taking rebar section, which is of 500 grade here. Click on OK option here. Again, we have to click on OK option here. Now we have to define the beam size and column size. For that, we have to select the define option, select the section properties, select to frame sections here, and we have to delete all this multiple section. Why? Because when you are assigning the property, new property, sometimes it will be visible your A column, A some beams here. But in order to avoid the confusion between the new beams or old beams, we have to delete these properties. So we can delete the properties by using single option also. Otherwise, you can directly delete these properties by using delete multiple properties. Select the multiple properties option, select here. Again, we have to select these two properties, delete here. So here in this case, at least one structural element will be exist. So that's why it is consisting of ISLB 600 here default. Firstly, we have to add the our required beam size and column size. Then after that, we will delete this particular property. For that, we have to click on the add new property option. Select the concrete option here. Just I am selecting the column C option. Just I am giving the notation as C, which is related to material of M25 grade. Then after that, we have to enter the depth of the column as well as the width of the column. As per our requirement, just I am entering rectangular column section, which is of 360 mm × 360 mm is the dimensions for the column. So after this, we have to click on the reinforcement option here and select the member to column here and select here as HYSD bar of 500. So you can enter your number of the bars in longitudinal direction, three direction as well as the two direction. So here in this case, just I am taking three number of the bars which is exist here and three number of the bars which is exist here. And longitudinal bar, just I am selecting here as a 16 mm diameter bar, and corner bar, just I am entering here as 20 mm diameter bar. And confinemental bar, you can enter as 8 mm, click on OK. So here in this example, just I was taking the rectangle. You can consider the rectangular also. If you want, you can consider the rectangle. But for your understanding, just I am taking rectangle also. No problem with the rectangle. Just I am taking width is approximately 230. Click on the modify show. You can modify your options according to your consideration. Click on OK. So now you can see it was done with the rectangular property. But here we have to change the cover. Just I am changing to 25 mm cover. Click on OK. Now we can see this is the column. So click on OK option. So select the ISLB 600. Click on delete property. Why? Because this property doesn't require to us. So click on add new property. Select the concrete section. Just I am taking the beam, which is consisting of the material of M25 grade provision, with depth as 300 and width as approximately 230 mm. Select the reinforcement option here. Select the beam option. From this option, we have to select the 500 grade. So just I am taking 25 is the top cover as well as the 25 is the bottom cover. Click on OK. Again, we have to click on OK option. So after defining the beam sizes and column sizes, we have to define the slab section. So this is the next task. Click on define option, section properties, select the slab section property. Click on delete property option, click on S option. Now we have to modify this property. So as per my consideration, just I am taking a slab thickness of 150 mm and material will be of M25 grade concrete with the thickness is 150 here. Click on OK option. So click on OK option here. So we are defined with the properties related to grade of the concrete, grade of the steel, as well as the dimensions for the beam section, column section, as well as the slab thickness. Now we have to assign the properties for the building. So for that, we have to select this simple second option. So I'm explaining simple steps to draw the beams and columns. So this is the second option, draw quick beams option here. Select this option. And we have to remember that the property is comes under your column here. But here the drawing method is related to beams. That's why we have to change the property from the column to beam here. And before drawing any beams or column section, we have to keep in mind, we have to keep the all stories option here. So we have to drag this model here like this so that it will draw the beam drawing section here like this. So it was done with the drawing of the beams. Now we have to select the I section, which is related to the columns. So we have to check the property is column or not. We have to assign this column property for the section here like this. Now we can see it was done with all the column drawing section. Now we have to draw the slab section. For that, we have to select this quick draw floors option here. And we have to pick the property according to IS slab 150 section. Draw to the whole model here like this. so that it will draw the slab section for the building structural model. Now we have to delete the property which is related to the slab at the ground story. For that, go to select option, select stories option here. From this, you have to select the base option, select the base, delete the property option. So that it will delete all the properties at the base here like this. Now you can see it was deleted with all the property at the base. So after modeling process completed, our next task is to do with the defining of the load cases and applying of the load cases. This is our second task. In first task is to create the properties as well as applying the property for the grid section. So we are done with that property section, which is related to the first step. And our second step is to, and second task is to related to defining the load cases and applying the load cases. So for that, go to click on the define option, select your load cases option. So otherwise you can directly go to select define option, load patterns option. So here in this example, in my previous video also, I was taken only the load cases related to the gravitational loading condition system, which is related to the dead loading condition system as well as the live loading condition system. In this video also, I will consider only the load cases which is related to the dead loading condition system as well as the live loading condition system for the building structure, which is related to gravity loads only. I am skipping the seismic loading condition system as well as the wind loading condition system. For simple understanding, I am skipping that topic. So you can watch the videos which is related to the seismic loading condition, wind loading condition in ETAP software. In my previous videos, I was uploaded. Plenty of the videos are available in the playlist. You can watch that videos. So here it was already defined with the dead loading condition system, live loading condition system. Our next task is to apply the load condition systems. So for that, we have to apply the self-weight condition system. So just I'm selecting all the building here for applying the self-weight condition system. Go to assign option here. Select the joint loads option. Select the forces option here. Click on select to add to existing loading condition. Just I'm giving the name is 111111. So here in this case, just I'm applying the global x direction forces as well as the moment global xx, yy, zz plane as 111. So if you apply this 111 loading condition system, it will apply to all the members like beams, columns and as well as the slabs. Click on apply option. So that it will apply the all the loading condition system for the one. So after this, we have to apply the wall loading condition system, which is related to the external wall loading condition system, internal wall loading condition system, and as well as the parapet wall loading condition system for the beams. So for applying the wall loading condition system, we have to select the beam sections. So for that, we have to click on the select option, select properties, frame sections, select the beams option here, close option, go to assign option, select the frame line load. So it will be consisting of the frame load only. Click on the distributed condition system. We have to apply as the distributed loading condition, and we have to apply as 24.3 kilonewton per meter is the intensity we have to apply. Click on apply option so that it will apply the wall loading condition system for the beams here like this. Click on OK. Then after that, we have to apply the floor load condition system for the slab. For that, go to click on select, select properties, slab section. Just I am selecting S150. Click on close option, assign option here, which is related to shell option only. So why? Because the area load will be comes under the shell only. That's why I am selecting here as shell. Add to existing. So here in this case, we have to apply here as 2 kilonewton per meter square. Depends upon our thickness as well as the material property. So here in the previous section also, I was taken 0.1 is the meter is the thickness of the floor, and multiply with the unit weight of the motor is 20, so that it can get the values approximately equal to 20 kilonewton per meter square. Click on apply option. Click on OK option here. Now after this, we have to apply the live loading condition. So for that, we have to select all the plates here by using previous section command. We have available with the PS previous section command here. So here it is there, all previous section clear. So go to assign option here, shell area load, uniform, change dead loading condition to live loading condition. So it will be consisting of approximately 2 kilonewton per meter square to 5 kilonewton per meter square. In this example, just I am taking 3 kilonewton per meter square is the intensity. Click on apply option. Click on OK option. Now after this, we have to define the load combinations. For that, go to click on define option, load combinations option, add a default design combination for the frames as well as the slab section. Click on OK option. Click on OK. so that it will add the load combination for this. Now we have to add the support condition systems. Go to select option, stories option, select the base option here. Again go to assign option, select the joint restraints, select the fixed support conditions here. So it will be consisting of hinge support, roller and point support. It will be fixed here. Click on apply. Click on OK option. So after this we had to do the analysis process. For that firstly we had to click on analyze option, check models option. Initially we need to check for the errors. So now we can see it is checking for the errors. So if the model is obtained with no warning messages, you can proceed with analysis process. Before that we will create one folder in the desktop. So just I am creating one folder etabs. Just I am going my etab software. Go to analyze option, set load case to run option. Select your available load cases, depends upon your consideration. Click on the run now option. So it will ask you to save the model. Just I am selecting etabs model. Just I am selecting as file name as E. Click on save option. So that the model will be do the analysis process with the considerations of the dead loading condition system as well as the live loading condition system. So now we can see this is the deflection diagram for the dead loading condition system. In order to see the shear force diagram, bending moment diagram, we can go to display option, forces, select the frames panel of force. You can select the shear to click on apply so that it will display the shear force diagram for the building structural model. In the same process, if you select the moment, so that it will select the see the bending moment diagram for the building structural model. So after analysis process completed, we have to design this particular structure. So before going to designing of this particular structure, firstly we had to add the strip conditions for the slab members. For that we have to unlock the model initially. Go to edit option, select the edit grid strips option, select the add edit grid strip condition. So here in this condition it will be consisting of the tower T1 with the story number of say 5th number with the grid direction is A X here. Click on apply so that it will apply the grid X direction with layer A at the top story. In the same process I am selecting Y direction condition with the B here. Click on apply so that it will apply the grid in Y direction condition system. In the same process we have to apply the grid condition system for the remaining floors. So here you can see I was applied the all the grid sections in X direction as well as the Y direction for the 5 stories. Click on OK option. Now we have to do the analysis again once again. For that click on the run analysis option again. So here it will do the analysis process once again. Then after that I will show you how to design this particular building structural model by using ETAP software as well as the detailing version software. Here you can see it was done with once again the analysis process. So go to design option here. So firstly we have to select the concrete design option. So concrete slab design section here, just I am selecting view revised preferences option, select here. And you can have to check initially the code will be consisting of IS 456 or not. Click on OK. Again we have to go to design, concrete slab design. So click on the start designing check option. Firstly it will ask you to select your floors. So here we are applied the grid section for the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 floors only. Just I am selecting here. Click on OK option. So that it will do the designing process for the slab section according to our considerations. So here you can see it was doing the designing section for the slab 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it was done with all the designing section. It will be consisting of your slab strip or intensity reinforcement diagram here like this. So pressure diagram here like this. Now we have to design the beam section design as well as the column section design. This is the important step. Go to design option, select the concrete preference frame design option, select the view revised preferences. We have to check, cross check this IS code 456 2000 code. So we have to click on the OK option. Again in the same process we have to click on the design option, concrete section, select the start designing check option so that it will start designing check for the beam sections as well as the column sections. So now we can see here it is showing some pink colors as well as the red color. So red color indicates the some beam sections or column sections which are failing here, and pink color indicates the reinforcement related to the particular beam section it is passing here. It will show you only the reinforcement design results for the particular pink color mark. If you want to design all the members with the pink color mark, so if we had to change the dimensions of the members, like beam size, column size. But here in this case, I am not changing any kind of the dimensions. Simply, I am saving this model. Just save this model. So click on the close option here. So we had to see the detailing designing results in the detailing version software. Just I am opening my detailing version software here. So click on the file option here. Select the new detailing option. So select the open EDB file. So we have to browse that file. Next I am selecting ETABS here, E-file here. So it will read the file in ETABS 18 version software. Then after that it will load the file, particular file in ETABS software, ETABS detailing version software. So it is extracting the data which is related to the frame sections, stories, joints, grids, as well as the shell sections. So it is showing some warning message here. Some beams and columns are not showing the reinforcement design results. Why? Because they are failed here. Click on OK. Initially, we had to select the slabs option. So you can check the details about the slabs, beams, columns. So firstly, we have to select the units. Select the units will be in metric system, user customization. So again, we have to select the millimeter as the length, millimeter as the section thickness, and millimeter for the spacing, and force will be in kilonewton here. And rest of the units we have to keep in constant. Click on OK. Select the preferences option and select as per use standard preferences as per IS 456-2000. Click on OK. Select the concrete preferences rules. So you can modify the names, otherwise you can keep it as constant. Just simple for understanding, just I'm taking here as beam and this is the column. Again I'm selecting here as wall deb. Click on OK. Select the display preferences. You can select your options, depends upon your consideration. Select the rebar rules option. This is the important step. So the minimum spacing we have to enter for the slab section. So the minimum spacing just I am taking here as 125 mm, and maximum spacing just I am taking here as let us consider 300 mm, just I am taking. And smallest bar size length just I am taking constant here. And we have to select the preferred bar size here. So column stirrups section just I am taking here as 12 mm diameter bar. Again this is also 12 mm diameter bar. Again I'm selecting another one is 12 mm and 12 mm, and select the beam. So we have to enter the minimum spacing option also here. So for the beam also just I'm taking 125 mm, and this is 125 mm, and this is 125 mm. In the same process I am entering the maximum spacing. Just I'm taking here as 300 here, and this is also 300, and this is also 300 here. And select the column here. Just I am taking the minimum spacing is 125, maximum spacing is here 300, just I am entering here. So click on OK option. So then after that we have to select the drawing or detailing also. So depends upon your consideration. Just I am directly simply selecting OK option here, so that it will start detailing for your respected model. So after this we can see the results part which is related to design results. So now we can see this is the slab detailing, beam detailing, column detailing. These three results are important for us. Just I'm selecting standard detailing initially. So it will be consisting of detailing typical store plan, elevation section, beam sections, and elevation section for that. This is the section A, beam section, and typical section here. And this is the column section and column stirrup section. And this is the medial strip section, and this is the medial strip. Now I'm selecting slab section. So it will be consisting of the bill of material and rebar quantities. It will be consisting of your respected quantities, units and items, and it will be consisting of the length, weight for the particular members of bars. And just I'm selecting fifth floor. For example, fifth floor is my slab. This is the floor framing plan, and this is the rebar section rule plan. This is top rebar plan, only the top section bars, and this is the bottom rebar plan, and this is all rebar plan section. This is all rebar plan section for the slab section. In the same process, top rebar plan here like this, bottom rebar plan here like this, and section A here like this, and section B here like this. And you can select the reinforcement profile layer, reinforcement profile layer B, and bill of materials and rebar quantities. So you can see the results related to strip results also. You can see the strip results like this. Okay. So in the same process, if you want to see the complete reinforcement diagram for the fifth slab, you have to select the rebar cage view option here. So it will take some time for loading the rebar cage view for the particular section. Now we can see this is the complete rebar cage view for the slab section. It will be consisting of the reinforcement bars here like this, which is related to slab results here. Okay, so this is the complete slab reinforcement design results for the particular slab. So this is the complete process of detailing of the building structural model in ETAP software. So you can see this is the top reinforcement section and this is the bottom reinforcement section for the particular slab section. So in the same process, I will show you the results part which is related to the beam. Select the beams here, concrete beams here. Select the framing plan here. This is the details and scheduling for the beam. So this is the beam detailing and scheduling. This is the bill of material, rebar quantity. You can select the beam layout plan also. Select the elevations and section. Select the fifth story. It will be consisting of the three beams here for the fifth story. Select the elevation section. This is the elevation section for the beam. This is the section A. This is the section B. And this is the reinforcement profile. This is the bill of material, rebar quantity, rebar cage view. So this is the complete rebar cage view for the particular beam section. It will be consisting of the reinforcement bars here like this. Okay. So in the same process, you can check the another reinforcement bars also, depends upon your considerations. Okay. So select the rebar cage view for this particular section so that it will load the rebar cage view for the section here like this. Now I will explain you how to see the results part for the column. Select the concrete column and select the framing plans here initially so that it will show you the center to center distance between the column and schedules and drawing here. So this is the schedule and drawing for the column and bill of materials and some results part. In the same process, select the elevation. So it is having only the one single column reinforcement design results. This is the elevation A1, elevation 2, this is the section. So it will be consisting of approximately 16 bars, 16 mm diameter bar for the whole section. It will be consisting of 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 numbers of the 16 mm diameter bar and 1, 2, 3, 4 numbers of the 22 mm diameter bar. So this is the section B results, section C, section D, section E. This is the bill of material and rebar quantity. So select the rebar cage view option so that it will load the rebar cage view for the particular column section. So this is the complete process of detailing in detailing version software. So this is the complete process of designing of the building structural model, G+4 building structural model by using ETAP software. If you have any queries about this video, please text me your questions in the below comment box. And you have to practice this model for getting the perfect results. So because of some reasons, my some of the beams and columns are failing here, but you have to apply the proper loading condition in order to get the perfect results. Thank you.